Hi, it's Angel Rose Songbird. Mary Magdalene, Jesus Christ's wife, and the Beatles' wife, Michelle. Okay, I want to tell you, at 4 years old, my mother called me. Come talk to her. She said, I never wanted you. I tried to abort you, but my ears started ringing like dinner bells, and I stopped the abortion. But this is Zig Ziglar. That's what I said. His self-help master. He says, if you want to succeed, offer something of value. If you want to succeed even more, offer something of more value. That's what Zig Ziglar said. It was wise. All right, so I spent years trying to figure out who rang the bell, okay? Who rang the bell to save my life, okay? And so it was Paul McCartney and John Lennon, the song, Michelle, My Bell. And it took me 30 years to realize that was a marriage proposal. Michelle, my wedding bell. Okay? And what else? All right, so that's good. So let's hear. And so Birdsong, I was dating him. Edwin Birdsong was Bach. Here it is. On our album. This is an album we did. It's the first album, What It Is. The second album, Supernatural. And so he said, I'm going to write a song about Michelle. And I said, well, the Beatles already wrote a song about Michelle. And he said, everything's been done with the way you do it. So then I said, Jesus Christ, has everything been done? He said, no. But after I play the song by the Beatles, I'll try to play the song that Birdsong wrote about Michelle. That's on the album, Supernatural. Okay, here we go. Paul is really singing a song. I really feel it.
I will say the only words I know that
All right, so, let me cut this off. So let's see. What am I saying? So Paul was the Count of Monte Cristo, and now was the Countess of Monte Cristo. So we didn't just meet this life; we were married before. And he told Edwin, when we started dating, he sent word, "No, leave her alone. That's my woman. That's my lady." So Edwin doesn't know that the big stars, everybody listens to them. He didn't listen, you know. Fuck you, you know. So, let's see if I can find, probably should cut this and turn this machine off and find the song that Edwin wrote about Michelle and let you see. Let's see, is there anything else I need to say? Paul is a vegan, as I'm a vegetarian. Neither one of us eats meat, fish, or eggs. He said anybody who goes to a slaughterhouse would not eat dead animals. And of course, one of my stepfathers worked in a slaughterhouse. So there's no such thing as a coincidence. So he was making reference to that. And so we used to sit in the car waiting for him to come out of the building to finish work. And you could smell the stink of dead animals outside. And he said he used to hit the cow in the head with a big sledgehammer to kill him. That's how he did. And he chewed tobacco to keep from vomiting, I think. So we would wash his clothes. Not only would they be bloody and disgusting, but wet tobacco would be in the washing machine. I mean, they really set me up to be a vegetarian because that was so disgusting. And he was a hunter. His name was Herschel Williams. They call him Shorty. And he was a veteran also. So he would go hunting and bring squirrels and throw them on the table, their bloody carcasses. I mean, you could vomit. It was unbelievable how gross all that was. Yeah. I was so skinny. I saw a picture of myself. I looked like somebody starving because I couldn't eat. I remember seeing a piece of meat and I said, "Oh my God, that's somebody's leg." And it was a chicken's leg, and I couldn't eat it. And my uncle, my love, Brother Wright, who was a sing bird song, a Sikh guru, and he came to see me because I was a majorette in a marching band, and he was looking away. And I couldn't understand why he was looking away. He was a Christian, and I thought it was a little short skirt offended him or something. But no, it was, he couldn't look at me. I was so emaciated. It looked like I was starving. And he couldn't bear to look at me. And when I saw that photograph, I could understand why. I was starving. So, alright, so I'm going to, let's see. What else about Paul? So Paul had seen our son, sitting with his band, Wings. Okay? I was an airline stewardess, one of the first black airline stewardesses. Graduation from stewardess college, they gave me a set of wings. Plus, I was a bird, so I had wings. I think it was... Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. So I don't know if I was the first bird or the blackbird, but I know I was a bird. Okay. so that they sing was a nightingale. And, they used to call women birds, in British, particularly, they may still do that. So the singers or birds, these are all birds. And Josh Groban, all these are just Josh Groban. All these people, they're birds. Yeah. Birds in human form, obviously. Okay. And so we were talking about what we're going to do for eternity. So Paul said he wanted to teach me to play the guitar, which I taught myself to play the guitar and when I was in Tennessee, and he knows this, but I forgot it because I didn't practice. So he wants me to get back into that because our sister Roberta Thorpe or something like that. She played the guitar and sang the blues. And he wants me to sing with the Beatles, so that's why I sing along when the songs come up. This is the best I can do, you know. Because it's so much fun, and because before they stole my voice, I was a singer. I was Mahalia Jackson, Etta James, Marian Anderson, Maria Callas is a white opera singer. I don't know, lots of singers, and I was a Charlotte Church, and so they want me to start singing again. I know my son was trying to get me to sing. I couldn't understand why he was trying to get me to sing. So then doing the research, that Jesus Christ took me all the way back to the beginning of time, and I saw that many lifetimes I was a singer, you know. So it's fun. That's why Sing wants me to do it. And you say, and because you have such a beautiful voice, Mom. So they told me to practice. Sing told me to practice. I can get my voice back. So I practice. I say, I pray you'll be our eyes. I'm so nervous. And watch us where we go. And help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Oh, this is awful. See, it's hard to sing and judge yourself at the same time. I remember my mother called me was washing dishes. She had come here. So I went and so she said, my mother had been Shirley Temple, which was a singing, dancing star, child star. So she said, I didn't know that at the time. She said, sing me a song. So I started singing her a song. And she said, oh, okay, stop. You could go wash dishes. And so, oh, okay. And so then I was taking singing lessons in San Fernando Valley. Years later, I grew up. So I was singing Climb Every Mountain from my favorite movie, The Sound of Music. And so it was so awful. The students laughed, and so I kept singing. I kept singing until I finished the song. So I was telling the story later, and I said, I'm satisfied because I finished the song. When I was singing the song for my mother, she would not let me finish. So I finished the song. The fact that they were laughing, I could give a fuck less.